attachments, upper end, the on tibia, the upper end, the intercondylar area from anterior to posterior side give attachments to following structures. First, anterior end of medial meniscus, anterior cruciate ligament, anterior end of lateral meniscus, posterior end of lateral meniscus, posterior end of medial meniscus, and lastly the posterior cruciate ligament. Since the upper end forms the important knee joint binding the two bones, that is the lower end of femur and upper end of tibia, are two cruciate ligaments. The menisci medial is oval. The menisci medial is C-shaped and lateral is circular. These provide smooth concave rim for the movements of knee joint. Anterior surface of lateral condyle gives attachment to iliotibial tract extending between the iliac crest above and tibia below. Into this tract, two muscles are inserted. These are tensor fasciae and 3/4 of huge postural gluteus maximus. The green one is the iliotibial tract extending from iliac crest above to the lateral condyle of tibia below. Into this, two muscles are inserted, the tensor fasciae from iliac crest and the huge postural gluteus maximus from the gluteal region. The groove on the posterior surface of medial condyle gets the insertion of semimembranosus muscle. This figure shows the origin of semimembranosus from the upper and lateral surface of ischial tuberosity and getting inserted into the posterior surface of medial condyle of tibia. Tibial tuberosity is an important landmark. In the upper part of this tuberosity is inserted the ligamentum patellae, which is the tendon of an extremely important muscle, the quadriceps femoris, the extensor of knee joint. Into the lower part of tuberosity is the subcutaneous infrapatellar.
Okay.
This figure shows ligamentum patelli and the tendons and the bursae related to that. In the lower part is subcutaneous infrapatellar bursa. Deep to it is deep infrapatellar bursa. In the upper part, deep to the vastus intermedius is the suprapatellar bursa, and in front of the patella is the prepatellar bursa. The upper part of medial border and adjoining medial surface gives attachment to the tibial collateral ligament. It also gives attachment to the insertion of sartorius from anterior superior iliac spine. To gracilis from the inferior pubic rami and semitendinosus from the ischial tuberosity. These are three muscles from three different compartments of the thigh. These three muscles get inserted close to each other in the tibia and they stabilize the pelvis on the leg bones like threads of a flying kite. The junction of lower 1/3 and middle one-third of the medial surface of tibia is crossed by the great or long saphenous vein. It is accompanied by the saphenous nerve. The great saphenous vein starts at the medial end of the dorsal venous arch, lies anterior to the medial malleolus. This particular vein is important as it is used for the venesection. The lateral surface of tibia. The upper two-thirds of lateral surface gives origin to tibialis anterior muscle. The posterior surface. Above soleal line is the insertion of intracapsular popliteus from the lateral femoral condyle. This muscle is the key for opening of the locked knee joint. Soleal line and part of medial border below soleal line gives origin to part of soleus muscle. It is also called the peripheral heart. Medial to vertical ridge is the origin of flexor digitorum longus muscle, and lateral to it arises part of tibialis posterior muscle. So both tibialis anterior and tibialis posterior arise from the anterior and posterior surfaces of tibia. Attached to the tip and borders of medial malleolus is one of the strongest ligaments of the body, called the deltoid ligament. It is triangular in shape. Apex is attached to the medial malleolus and broad base is attached to the navicular. Spring ligament, sustentaculum tali. Medial surface of talus and the posterior surface of talus.